I'd like to introduce you to the next poet. Her name is Renoun, and she writes poetry in English, and she expresses a lot of her poetry from the struggles of this area, from the spirit of the area that we live in. Renoun, she runs her own open mic show in two cities, one in Grosse Pointe, right? And the other one is in
Farmington
Hills. So she runs two open mics, and she's a poet herself. I'd like to introduce you, Renoun.
Mother. I have never met my mother. She did not raise me, though she is the one from which I came at least 75 to 80% of me. This according to DNA 23 or ancestry.com. I do not know. I do know that God gathered soil of her lands. It is evident in the melanin in the skin tone that my skin has shown since birth. The very chromosomes that ordered the pigment in the irises of my eyes wish only to see her in themselves. My hair curls on her cue, paying homage in my physical attributes that only she, my mother, could have bestowed upon me. I am the begotten from many generations of her lost and stolen children, transplanted to grow up in lands on the other side of the Atlantic and deep in the Caribbean Sea, all the while remembering vast lands ripe in Edenesque. While I can't recall the name of the country, uncertain of the specific regions, there are unconscious memories that whisper that the Nile runs through me. From Angola and Algeria to Zambia and Zimbabwe, you carry 54 countries wrapped in a chitenge on your back. The Afrocentric diaspora is transcontinental and global, and though our languages differ and our customs may vary, we keep you with us in our blood, in our cellular structure, in our beings, in our soul stories, and in all of our glory. Oh, Mother, our Mother, Africa.